next category, that is after the protozoans, bacteria, viruses, protozoans. The fourth category, that is of the helminthus members. The fourth type of the organisms that which causes the diseases, and the two diseases that we have to study for this. First, we have already discussed, that is the ascariasis. Okay, so now today we are going to discuss the second disease, that is elephantiasis. Or it is called as filariasis. Filarial worm. Filariasis, right? So this is the elephantiasis or filariasis disease, which is caused by a member, that is Vacheria bancrofti. What is the causal agent for this, or the causative agent for this, or the organism that causes it? It is Vacheria bancrofti. Or we can also call it as the filarial worm, that which are responsible for causing the diseases, called as filariasis. Okay, the two of the species of the Vacheria are there, that is bancrofti, as well as another, that is malai, that is M-A-L-A-Y-I. Okay, the Vacheria bancrofti, that is the major causal agent for this particular disease, elephantiasis. As the name is saying, elephantiasis means the organs that shows the chronic type of the symptoms, in which they become, you can say, swollen, the lymphatic vessels, etc., they become swollen, and even the organs, they get swollen. They are like increased in their sizes to that extent that it can't be treated or operated any further. Okay, so those are the symptoms of this particular disease. The picture is also there in your NCERT books, if you see, that shows the symptoms of the elephantiasis, and that is also in the lower areas, that is in the lower portions it starts with, because there is the less supply of the blood which reaches to it, and so the organs, they are becoming non-functionable. Okay, so what are the next, that are the symptoms. So on an average, if we talk about, the symptoms are all chronic in nature. Okay, so what we write here is the chronic inflammation of organs is the basic symptom seen within the for the person which is suffering with this disease, that is the elephantiasis. Okay, another symptom, this also affects the lymphatic vessels or the lymphatic organs. Lymph system, okay, the lymph system is also affected by this, right? The genital organs are also affected by the disease. This affects the genital organs, leading to the deformities in the organism, right? So this affects the genital organs, that leads to the deformities. That is, the structural deformities are noticed within this particular person who is suffering with the disease, that is elephantiasis, right? How is this disease spread, or how it is transmitted from one person to the another? This is, again, it requires the particular vectors which are like that of the mosquitoes, the female mosquito. For example, the female Culex mosquito is to carry this particular vector, this particular causal agent, microbe, that is a Vacheria bancrofti. Okay, for specifically Vacheria bancrofti, the Culex mosquito is there. Otherwise, the female mosquitoes, they can all be in this category, like Aedes, Anopheles, Culex, all can be there involved for the spread of this particular disease, right? So this is the female mosquitoes that act as the vectors for this particular disease, right? So this is the disease called as elephantiasis or filariasis. Clear? So this is the category, fourth category of the organisms, that is the helminthus. After bacteria, virus, protozoans, helminths, now comes the fifth category, that is of the fungal diseases. Anji, have you noted it down? Have you noted it down? Anybody still writing? Okay. So coming to the next, that is the fifth category of the members. That is a fungi member. And only one disease is there, that is ringworms, that which we have to discuss here. Ringworm is a very common skin disease. It's a skin problem, you know. So this is the fifth category of the members causing the disease. Now you can be asked a question like, name the different types of the organisms which are responsible for causing the diseases. So there are five. Give examples of all those microbes also. Yeah, give example of all those organisms which are responsible for causing diseases. Then you will be giving the example of the microbes, of the organism causing disease, or the disease which is caused by those organisms. Okay, both ways. आपको जैसा भी question आता है, you can write that. So this is a disease. It is a skin disease, ringworms. You might be commonly knowing this particular disease. Anji. Anyone who knows what are the symptoms of this particular disease? Anyone who knows what are the symptoms of this particular disease? किसी को पता है? याद करो थोड़े से. If you have heard of it, तब तक हम लिखते हैं इसके causal agent. Just think of it that what are the disease symptoms? This ringworm के symptoms क्या क्या हैं? What are the causal agents for this? There are different organisms of the fungal member that which are involved in causing of this particular disease. Number one is Microsporum. Secondly, it can be Trichophyton. And the third is Epidermophyton. So these are the members that which can be involved in causing the particular disease, that is ringworm. Trichophyton, Epidermophyton, and Microsporum. आए किसी को याद इसके symptoms? Ringworm skin disease है? Nobody, no one has heard of this particular disease, ringworm. No. Have you seen the ad of that ring guard? Ring guard की ad देखी है आप लोगों ने? If you have seen, then you might be knowing those particular dry lesions जो उसके ऊपर skin के ऊपर नजर आते हैं. In the ad also they do show within the fingers, that is on your palm, within the fingers, or basically it happens in the groin area. That is the groins means the area between the stomach, lower abdominal portion में stomach and the thighs. ठीक है? The area that is the groin area. उसके अंदर usually ये lesions जो हैं या scaly dry skin जो है वो नजर आती है. बस usually यहाँ पे अगर बन जाए because of the moisture basically or because of the discharges that are happening because of the vaginal discharges or the other external discharges from the body, if they are sweating can be there even, so that leads to the these microbes to become active, right, leading to the skin problems, and that is called as a ringworm. Okay, the disease that is causing the that is caused is called as a ringworm disease. Okay, so this is the symptoms mein likho isme, that is the dry and scaly lesions they are seen over the skin, over the various you can say areas on the whole body, okay, or simply over the skin. So we can write the appearance of dry or scaly lesions on the skin. Even sometimes these lesions they are accompanied by itching, redness भी हो जाती है उस area में, itching भी होनी शुरू हो जाती है, ठीक है? So that is also accompanied by, can also be accompanied by itching, and this is very you can say kind of a disease which spreads very quickly, as if you are having the this particular problem and infection on any of your body parts, if that body part even that used to touch continuously, like आपका अगर हाथ पे ही है और आपका हाथ usually आपके किसी और body organ को touch करता रहता है, face पे या आपके hand पे या anywhere else, like अगर आपके body organs in contact रहते हैं जहाँ पे ringworm हुआ है, so it can spread from the one part to the another even in the same body, ठीक है? So it is that infectious, so ये एक ही body में भी touch के साथ आगे फैल सकती है, so it can also spread from one person to the another by sharing of the articles or the objects, ठीक है? कुछ भी materials अगर हम इसमें sharing करते हैं इस organism के साथ, who is suffering from this particular thing, like the towels and the hankies and everything, if the person is using it on the infected areas, then this can also be separated from one person to the another. So usually the person, and even we can not cover it, ठीक है, हम उसको cover करके भी नहीं रख सकते, ऐसा नहीं है कि bandage लगा लिया जाए उसके ऊपर हम लोग पट्टी बांध ले, है ना, तो ऐसा बैंडेज भी नहीं हम लगा सकते, कवर नहीं कर सकते, क्योंकि अगेन द सेम, इफ इट विल बी कवर्ड द मॉइस्चर विल बी लॉक्ड विद इन इटसेल्फ, है ना, तो उस कवर के अंदर मॉइस्चर जो है वो फिर से लॉक रहेंगे, एंड ऑल्सो दीज माइक्रोब्स विल बी मोर इफेक्टिव देयर, ठीक है, तो मोर इज द मॉइस्चर एंड मोर इज द हीट प्रोड्यूस्ड इवन बाय द बॉडी पार्ट एंड ऑल्सो द केमिकल थिंग्स विच आर क्रिएटेड बाय योर बॉडी, इफ दे आर ऑल कमिंग इन कंटैक्ट, सो द माइक्रोब्स दे विल बी क्रिएटिंग दिस पर्टिकुलर डिजीज, राइट. So this is the end of the different diseases that we have studied. Here is particularly what we have noticed is whatsoever the diseases are, may it be caused by a bacteria, a virus, a protozoan, a fungal member, a helminth member, anything, right? कुछ भी है, कैसे भी microbes हैं, जितनी भी diseases आप लोगों ने पढ़ी, उनमें एक चीज common हमने यही पढ़ी है, that is because of the certain unhygienic conditions only these diseases are there, है ना? Unhygienic condition of our own body, that is the skin, unhygienic conditions of the surroundings, for example, which lead to the contaminations of the food and the water, leading to the diseases like that of the amoebiasis ho gaya, ya phir malaria, jaise humne kal padha, plasmodium, mosquito breed karte hain stagnant water ke upar, hai na? So ye kya hai, basically the diseases, they are more predominantly, they are caused just because of the conditions that you are not healthier or your surroundings are not healthy, means the hygienic conditions are either not followed by you or by your surroundings, that you are not taking care of your surroundings being hygienic, so that is what it is leading to the diseases. If we create this particular problem for long, then obviously we have to suffer with these diseases. Agar hum aise hi problem banate rahe, agar hum apne aap ko bhi saaf safai nahi rakhte, अगर हम लोग अपनी सराउंडिंग्स में साफ सफाई नहीं रखते हैं, हाइजीन नहीं रखते हैं, देन ऑब्वियसली द डिजीजेस आर गोइंग टू स्प्रेड फॉर लॉन्ग, है ना. सो व्हाट वी नीड टू डू एज अ गुड सिटीजन ऑल्सो, वी नीड टू फर्स्टली वी नीड टू टेक केयर ऑफ अवर ओन सेल्फ, दैट इज हम लोग को अपने आप के लिए अपनी हेल्थ की जो ध्यान है वो रखना है, बिकॉज नाउडेज अगेन आप लोग को पता है जैसे कोविड है, ठीक है, द थर्ड वेव इज अगेन ऑन द स्टार्ट, है ना, हो चुका है ऑलमोस्ट, एंड देन the news they are coming like ki just in a few days, that is after a few days it will be at the highest peak, hai na, so that is why the students, they are locked at their homes, that is they are not allowed to come to the schools, why, that is because the conditions are not good, surroundings are not good, hai na, conditions means surroundings, we people are not responsible actually, hai na, agar hum apni baat kare, are we going out and wearing the mask, no, abhi ye piche corona khatam ho gaya tha and everybody was like saying ki theek hai theek hai ab to third wave bhi nahi aayega, which is wrong, hai na, wrong to say this, because if every country has suffered from these particular stages, then definitely it will be there itself, yahan pe bhi hoga, hai na, but still the people, they forgot to wear the mask, the people, they forgot to sanitize their hands, that is what the hygienic conditions are, that is what the healthier conditions are, and if we are not following the healthier conditions, we are following the diseases, then हम लोग को खुद ही फेस करनी पड़ती है वो डिजीजेस, ठीक है, अगर हम ही हेल्थ नहीं बना के रखना चाहते ना अपनी ना सराउंडिंग्स की, तो डिजीज तो फिर है ही है हमारे पास, ठीक है, तो वो डिजीजेस को हमें खुद ही फॉलो, मतलब हमें खुद ही देखना पड़ेगा और खुद ही झेलना पड़ेगा उन डिजीजेस के. सो व्हाट वी नीड टू डू इज फर्स्टली द चैरिटी बिगिंस फ्रॉम द होम, है ना, तो जब भी आप लोगों ने शुरुआत करनी है, टू कीप द सराउंडिंग्स नीट एंड क्लीन हाइजीनिक, यू नीड टू फर्स्ट स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम योरसेल्फ, राइट. Start following the precautions for yourself, then ask the other people of your families to start following those precautions, continuously clean your houses, जो हम लोग sanitizations करते हैं, जैसे आप लोग के classrooms की होती थी ये sanitization, है ना, तो हम लोग अपने घरों में भी ये चीजें कर सकते हैं, ठीक है, so start following these all precautions, you have to provide these to your parents, to your family members, to other maids and everything, those who are coming to your homes, you will be giving them the awareness, and similarly from them it will be shared to the other people, so there is like from aap se ye shuruaat hui, to aage 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 aapke paas kitne sare levels of the people, those who are in contact with you people, hai na, to unke sath milte hue aapko ye sari jo hai डिजीज जो है आप उसको इरेडिकेट कर सकते हो, डिजीजेस होने के जो चांसेस हैं वो खत्म हो जाते हैं, डिजीजेस होने के जो पॉसिबल रीजंस हैं वो खत्म हो जाते हैं, एंड हेंस वी कैन बी हेल्दियर आवरसेल्व्स इवन एंड इवन अवर सोसाइटीज, ठीक है. So what are the various, you can say, steps that we should follow for getting ourselves healthier or for making our maintaining our hygienic conditions in our surroundings also. So that is to look over your health as well as to look over the public health. Okay, maintaining the hygiene for yourself as well as the public hygiene. Okay, so ye sare steps agar hum follow karte hain, then definitely we will be having a disease-free environment in which we are going to stay healthier, not the other things that which are going to stay healthier. Hai na? Agar hume hi diseases nahi milengi, hum log apne liye hi ye sari cheeze karenge. And we are to just allow the other people, we are to just aware them regarding these particular conditions. Okay, so this was all about the diseases jo humne abhi padhi hai. So the first part of your this chapter that has been done, that is the diseases. What are the various diseases? What are the various organisms causing it? What are the various symptoms, spread, how it has been spread? So these are all the conditions what we have discussed for the various of the diseases. The first portion of this chapter is complete. Now coming to the second portion of the chapter, that is your immunity. Okay. Why I'm talking about these portions? Because there are three separate portions of your this chapter, not separated as such in your NCERT, but they are. First is about the diseases, second is about the immunity, and third is about the drugs. है ना, तो इन तीनों पोर्शंस में से आपको क्वेश्चंस जो हैं वो आते हैं इस पेपर्स में, आपके जो आपका सब्जेक्टिव या ऑब्जेक्टिव जो भी पेपर होगा आपका टर्म टू में, उस पेपर में आपको तीनों पोर्शंस में से इक्वलेंट नंबर ऑफ क्वेश्चंस, इक्वल मार्क्स में ये पेपर में क्वेश्चंस आते हैं. बिकॉज दिस चैप्टर इज होली सोली इम्पॉर्टेंट. इन अ फ्यू चैप्टर्स व्हाट वी से इज दिस टॉपिक इज मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट दैन द अदर. है ना, हम यूजली ऐसा करते हैं, पर यहाँ पे ऐसा नहीं है. यहाँ पे हर पार्ट जो है इसका, दैट इज इक्वली वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, एंड एनीथिंग कैन बी आस्क्ड फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर. ओके, सो वी आर डन विद द फर्स्ट पार्ट. नाउ कमिंग टू द सेकंड पार्ट, दैट इज इम्यूनिटी. एनीबडी हैविंग एनी क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम दिस? ये जो मैंने अभी कंक्लूजन में बोला, दैट इज ऑल अबाउट द योर ओन हेल्थ एंड द हाइजीन एंड द पब्लिक हेल्थ एंड द हाइजीन. दैट इज अगेन द कंक्लूजन मेड अगेंस्ट दिस पर्टिकुलर डिजीजेस. हाउ कैन वी प्रिवेंट आवरसेल्व्स और आवर सराउंडिंग्स from the diseases. Okay, haan ji, anybody else having any question, any doubt till this? No. Okay, so we start with the other part, that is now coming to the immunity. What is immunity, anyone? Can anyone please define what is immunity? Raise your hands. What is immunity? हाँ जी, इम्यूनिटी यू हैव स्टडीड इन योर लोअर क्लासेस सो मेनी टाइम्स. व्हाट इज इम्यूनिटी? रेज योर हैंड बेटा, रेज योर हैंड्स. इम्यूनिटी इज व्हाट? इट इज द एबिलिटी ऑफ वन्स बॉडी टू फाइट अगेंस्ट द डिजीजेस, फाइट अगेंस्ट the diseases. Okay, to fight against the diseases is the ability, that ability is called as a immunity. Okay, ab hamari body mein agar main simple sa example leti hu, that a person is suffering with the common cold, and in the class that a person is suffering with the common cold, there are 30 more students, right? One who is suffering is the 30th student, and the 29 other students will not fall sick because of the common cold. ठीक है, अगर इन केस वो नहीं, मतलब दोबारा उनको भी कॉमन कोल्ड नहीं हो पाता, दे डू नॉट कैच दैट कॉमन कोल्ड फ्रॉम द 30th स्टूडेंट ऑफ द क्लास, देन दैट मींस ऑल द 29 दे आर हैविंग द वेरी गुड इम्यूनिटी, राइट? उनकी इम्यूनिटी अच्छी थी, उनके अंदर ये इम्यूनाइजेशन पावर जो थी वो अच्छी थी, दैट इज वाई दे कुड फाइट विद द डिजीज विच वॉज जस्ट नेक्स्ट टू देम, फॉर द पर्सन हु इज सिटिंग जस्ट नेक्स्ट टू देम. है ना, तो अगर ये इम्यूनिटी हमारी स्ट्रांग कैसे होती है, अगर ये स्ट्रांग है तो कैसे होती है? That is by having the good healthy conditions in our body. Again with the good health only. ठीक है, if you are eating good healthy diet, अगर आप healthy diet खाते हैं, अगर आप अच्छा खाना खाते हैं, अगर supposing आप लोगों का जो food three meals हैं आपकी food की, you are including out of three, the two of the meals they are the junk foods and one meal you are skipping it out. So will you be having the good health? No. Will you be having the good immunity? No. right? So avoid eating the junk food, especially in your age when it is the adolescent age is going on and you are under the growth changes, that is your body is undergoing the various changes, biological changes are there within your body. So during those particular ages, especially, we say that the person should not be having the particular junk foods, and right? Should not be in a habit of eating the junk foods. So because if we are getting the healthy diet, our immunity will also be healthier. Okay. So now, what are the different types of the immunity that which we have to study? Here we have to study the two types. The first is the innate immunity. What is that innate immunity? The first type of the immunity is innate. As the name says, innate means the one which is present in our body by birth. Okay, so this type of immunity is seen in our body. It can be present in our body, that is by birth. Already humare andar ye by birth present hai, that is an innate immunity. The other type that which we usually acquire during the lifespan, that is hum log jab bhi like during the lifetime, jaise chicken pox ho gaya kisi ko, and then the antibodies are built in through the memory cells. After that, agar chicken pox second time hota hai to wo nahi इफेक्ट कर पाता उसी सेम बॉडी को. ठीक है, तो ऐसे में जब ये होता है तो दिस इज द एक्वायर्ड टाइप ऑफ इम्यूनिटी दैट द पर्सन गेट्स थ्रू द लाइफ. ठीक है, दैट इज व्हेन यू आर इन अ लाइफ एंड दैट टाइम यू आर अचीविंग समथिंग, यू आर एक्वायरिंग सम न्यू इम्यूनाइजेशंस लाइक थ्रू वैक्सीनेशंस आल्सो. सो दैट आर द एक्वायर्ड इम्यूनिटी. सो दिस इज द इननेट इम्यूनिटी व्हिच इज देयर विद इन अवर बॉडी बाय बर्थ. ठीक है, सो व्हाट इज दिस इननेट इम्यूनिटी कॉज्ड ड्यू टू? दिस इज because of the presence of certain of the barriers within our body, that which does not allow the microbes to be entered into our body. If they enter, then there will be definitely the changes which will be made, either our body will win or the microbes causing the diseases, right? I'm telling you, immunity, that is innate immunity, that is by birth in our body, and it is a non-specific type of the defense because it is created because of certain barriers. That is why we call it as a non-specific type of defense. Hum isko kyun non-specific type of defense keh rahe hain? Kyunki ye kisi barriers ki wajah se, kyunki already nature ne kuch barriers lagaye. For example, our skin is there. Skin is our barrier, hai na? To sabse bada hamara physical barrier kya hai? That is the skin only. So skin being the first barrier type, that is a physical barrier type. This is taking care of many of the microbes that which could not enter into our body, hai na? Kitne microbes hai hamari body mein jo hamari skin ki wajah se to enter hi nahi ho sakte. Ab agar chot lag jati hai, immediately hum log usko kya hai, clean karte hain with the Dettol or the Savlon types, hai na? Kyun unko hum log clean karte hain? So that no of the microbes should enter through the wounds even into our body. हमारी बॉडी को मतलब प्रॉपरली सिक्योर्ड फॉर्म में अच्छे से रखने के लिए द फर्स्ट बैरियर दैट इज अ फिजिकल बैरियर मेड बाय द नेचर व्हिच वी गेट बाय बर्थ दैट इज अ स्किन. ठीक है, अलोंग विद दिस देयर इज आल्सो द म्यूकस व्हिच इज सिक्रीटेड विद इन द सर्टन ट्रैक्ट्स लाइक देयर इज अ रेस्पिरेटरी ट्रैक्ट, है ना? देन इन पर्टिकुलर ट्रैक्ट्स और भी हैं, जैसे हमारे रेस्पिरेटरी रिप्रोडक्टिव ट्रैक्ट्स हैं. ठीक है, तो उन चीजों में द म्यूकस सिक्रीशन और द म्यूकस कोटिंग्स आर आल्सो प्रोवाइडेड. गैस्ट्रोइंटेस्टाइनल ट्रैक्ट इज देयर. सो उन सब में अगर इन केस हमारे माउथ से जैसे एंटर कर भी गए हैं इन द नेचुरल ओपनिंग्स, अगर एंटर कर भी जाते हैं माइक्रोब्स, देन देयर इज अनदर बैरियर दैट इज विद इन द लाइनिंग ऑफ द पर्टिकुलर ऑर्गन्स और द सिस्टम्स विद इन अवर बॉडी, एंड दैट इज अ म्यूकस कोटिंग. ठीक है, विच इज ऑल्सो एक्टिंग एज अ फिजिकल बैरियर. Okay, another three types of the barriers innate immunity ke under we will be studying it tomorrow, and so you should also read it through the NCERT thoroughly.